How do I delete multiple emails when I've got a lot to delete? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not subscribed to Confident Computing, my weekly newsletter, visit newsletter.askleo.com and sign up today. Every Tuesday you'll get tips, tricks, and answers to various problems and concerns, well, like this one. So it's not at all uncommon to suddenly find yourself in a situation where you have a bunch of email that you need to delete. And depending on the email program you're using, it can be easy or it can be hard. I want to point out that while I'll be using Outlook.com as our example for this video, the techniques are more important than the specifics. I say that because you may use a different email program. You may use a different web interface. They share some commonality. They share some of these common tools and techniques that I want to point out, but they'll be just a little bit different. So take these tips and tricks and make sure to look into how they will apply to whatever it is you happen to be using for your email program. So you can see here that I have multiple emails in this Outlook.com account. And in fact, because it has so much in it, deleting a bunch of them might not be a bad idea. So let's do that. To begin with, I'm going to just click on one. Now, if we wanted to just delete this email, I could just click on delete and it would go. I want to click multiple emails. That's kind of the point here, right? So the next thing I'm going to do then is use Ctrl click. If I Ctrl click and click another email, now both of these emails are selected. Now I could go through and Ctrl click, which is nothing more than holding down the Ctrl key while you click on a message, and select each of the individual messages that I might want to delete. If I click on delete right now, those two messages will be deleted. Maybe that's not enough, or maybe that just means you've got a whole lot of individual clicking to do. There's another approach. I'm going to click on this top one here just to make sure that we've got a selection that's unrelated to what I'm about to show you. Let's say we want to select or we want to delete all of the emails we can see down below here, but not the ones up on top. I'll click on the first one that I want to delete, and then going all the way down to the bottom, this time holding down the Shift key, I'll click on the last one. By definition, the Shift click selects everything between what's currently selected and what you clicked on. So all of the messages in between got selected and I can now delete them. Okay, great. We've got a couple of different ways to select a lot of emails. There's one more that I want to show you that is perhaps overkill unless you are literally wanting to delete absolutely every email in your inbox. And that is Ctrl A. If I type Ctrl A, now I've selected all of the emails, every single one of them. That way, if I now hit delete, which you'll notice has disappeared, I can still right-click on it and you'll find delete down here somewhere. Right at the top, actually, you can still delete all of the messages in your inbox in one fell swoop by using Ctrl A to select all of them and then clicking on delete. Obviously, I'm not going to do that. I want to save at least the test email here at the top. Now, along with these different modes of selection, there are other things that are important to understand. You'll notice that if we select one, and then shift select another, we're selecting all of the ones in between. That's kind of interesting. Right now, all of my emails are sorted by date. If I take a look at filter, you can see that here, sort says it's sorted by date. On the other hand, if I wanted to delete all the emails from a specific person, for example, I would instead sort by from. Now, I can see, for example, down here at the bottom, I've got these two messages from Microsoft Account Team. I don't want them. I'll click on one, I'll shift or control click on the other, and now I've got just those two. Doesn't matter when they were sent, because we sorted by who the email was sent from, They're grouped together, and I can use the various selection techniques I've talked about to select only those messages and then hit delete. You'll notice also that when I click on multiple messages, or when I click on any message, there's a little checkbox here. If you like, you can use that. Much like Control Click, you can now click on individual messages to be operated on. Personally, I find Shift Click and Control Click easier. Not all email programs have the checkbox approach, but this is also another handy way to select the messages that you want to delete. So hopefully that gets you started. Hopefully that gives you a way of basically deleting a whole bunch of email without deleting the email you want to keep. I am going to point you at the companion article for this video, askleo.com/17401. It includes a couple of additional topics that are important, especially if you're using Gmail. Gmail, you can still do all of this, except because they don't have column sorting, you need to be a little fancier about how you select which emails you want to delete. It's not hard, but it is covered in the article. Again, that's askleo.com/17401. Hopefully this is helpful. I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. Thanks for watching.